Welcome to clickmateproject.com.
The project title is The Mash and Dash, a defense against the cyber attacks in wireless networks without trusted authority. Next one is here, abstract. In abstract, the cyber node impresses the other nodes by broadcasting message with a multiple node identifier in contrast to existing solutions which are based on the sharing encryption. The problem based on the received signals and indicator readings and messages. Our solution is robust since it detects all cyber attack cases with 100% completeness and less than the few percent false and the positives. Our solution is a lightweight of the sense that alongside the receiver we need to collaboration for one other node, that is only one message communication for our protocol. In this process we show through the experiment then even through RSSI is a time varying and unreliable in general and through radio transmission is non-isotropic using a ratio of RSSI from multiple receivers it is feasible to overcome these problems too. In this process we extend the signal print based cyber detection methods to work without a period trust in any observer allowing any participant in an open wireless networks to determine which of these one hope neighbors and non-cibel to produce a set of a non-cibel identifiers. Then cibel identifier is much worse than the temporarily rejecting the some conforming nodes that are currently moving. In this existing system, the system used the channel-based authentication technique to detect the cibel attack in wireless network utilizing the uniqueness of the channel response in the rich. So, by exploring the channel estimations, which is already the perform in the most wireless network. The disadvantage of the existing system, the rely on the trusted external measurement, that restrict the attack model to the stationary devices, even though attackers can initially use the mobile devices. A primary drawback of this class of work is its restriction to specified hardware. Firmware was commodity 802.11 devices not exposed detailed channel information to the receivers. Proposed system we have to introduce the first method gives the partial separation bounding the network. Next one is the flow diagram. In flow diagram we have to introduce the node deployment and the network formation. Next is a mash and test is combined with the RSSI validations and the process will be the RSSI validation. Then network comparisons of the process. Next one is the detect the malicious attackers to previous signal print of the mechanisms and the data transmission will occur analyzing the results. In the previous signals printer method will be introducing the detect the malicious attack to analyze the result. The analyzing result we have to convert as a malicious that the packet delivery issue throughput delay and then quality of service parameters. These are all the overall network formations for the flow diagram for the mash and test process. In mash and test, three process will RSSI validation, identify the malicious node and detect the malicious nodes. These are all the flow diagram for mash and test. Next one is here simulations. In simulation process we have to go to the roots home and then open the terminal of the process and then mash and go to the mash and test, open the terminal, type the command as sacd space mash and test and then command like after that we have to type the cd space mash and test and then type as a ls, then go to the ls ns ss1.tcl you have to enter the number of malicious node at say 5, whatever it is you have to type it as a number of malicious node, it's a dynamic changes. In this one is at the same time it will be declared as a at the time 43 and 46 time what is the position of x axis y axis for the each and every node it will be calculating like this. After completing the network running procedure we have to connect as a network animator window, type as a NAM. In this process we have to calculate this how to try the transmission will occur in this process and then open the network animator file, open the file and the new one dot NAM. Next the network formation with the highest energy level will be declared here. Source and center and destination we have to click like this one. After we have to already we have entered the CIBIL node counting as a 5, so 5 node will be declared. The CIBIL node will be identification. After the CIBIL node identification, the deduction will occur, the data transmission will occur. These and all the modules for the CIBIL node attack to the process. These are the match and test process. In this process we have to communicating with the source and destination. In the process it will be transmitting the information from source to destinations. The malicious node, whenever the malicious node across the data transmission, it will be accept and but it not will retransmit the information to the another node. If it will be lost the information, that will be the characteristics of the CIBIL node process. This CIBIL node will be configured in the based of security process. We have to include the security to detect the malicious node for the process. That's why the PDR information signature problem will be declared here. After complete the CIBIL node attack declaration part, the network animator window will be closed. After that we have go for the graph procedures. Then command like say ls, then find out the process, gnu plot delay dot plot simresult.txt. First we have to how much packet we have to send and how much packet we have to receive. Then what is the end to end delay, what is the throughput, we have to analyze like this. Then total packet received and simulation end time, then total delivery time and then delivery reply message and number of hop nodes and all analyzing in the simresult.txt. After that we have to find the gnu plot space delay dot plot. Delay dot plot, these are the with attack, without attack we have to find the delay. If you have without attack means the malicious process will occur, then no go for the GNU plot space GNU plot mash and test dot plot. Mash and test, these are the proposed system, the mash and test will occur like this. After this GNU plot space will be the GNU plot. After the PDR dot plot, packet delivery, how much packet with attack, without attack, how much packet will occur in the process. Without attack means the packet delivery will be there very high when compared to the existing system. Next is the PDR. After PDR we have to find out the throughput dot plot. How much throughput means how much packet received divided by simulation time. These and all the throughput packet